Avenue, and then we'll take it higher. Oh no, we're gonna rock down to holding just behind the bridge. He lays her down, he frowns. Do my life's a funny thing. Am I still too young? Kissed the diamond there. She took his ring, took his babies. It took him minutes, took her nowhere. Never knows she's a taken in her brain. Was a young American. She was a young American.
say.
Yes, sir.
The Reverend Baggett said it today. Let's love one another.
Amen. Amen.
And let's take it, men. Hey, just go for it.
All right.
Mighty proud of you. Enjoy this, and this is one you'll remember a lifetime. You can put this one back and tell your grandchildren about it when you're old man in gray.
But don't ever doubt the things that we've talked and preached all year long will win.
This is it. And it ain't going nowhere but up from here.
Go back out there and thank our people.
The Auburn Football Review with Coach Pat Dye. Brought to you by...
Welcome to the Auburn Football Review. 60,000 fortunate folks saw the football game of their lives last night in Tallahassee. Auburn 42, Florida State 41. That was the score, wasn't it?
Well, I looked up at the clock and it was, 36 to 41? Yeah. And I'm sitting there thinking, all right, we score, we got to go for two, because if the touchdown's going to put us one ahead of 2 points or make us three ahead, and they'll have to kick a field goal to tie us, and... You know, that's the way the game was all night long. You're trying to decide whether you're going for one or going for two or going for the field goal or whatever. But it was an all-time great football game.
Most remarkable one I've ever seen.
I've never been in one like it as a head football coach, and never played in one like that, because of the momentum. And I don't know that anybody ever had the momentum, because it swapped back and forth. We couldn't stop either. They couldn't stop us, and we couldn't stop them. And there was a lot of big plays on the kicking game, and so many long plays in the ball game. And Florida State, you got to give them credit. Coach Baden and his staff had, an excellent game plan both ways, and I think we did. They just executed, and they hurt us in the passing game, running game, and we hurt them with the passing game and the running game. And they got a big play off a kicking game. We got a big, got a touchdown off a kicking game. I think it just, it boiled down to, we had the ball last. And I don't think I've ever been into a game in my life where I felt like the cards were stacked against us as much as they were last night, because of the environment in Tallahassee. And when we got in there, the news media, you could read the papers, and it looked like it was written by Coach Bowden, getting the folks psyched up and the players psyched up.
And they were. The crowd was in
that game. And, of course, they've got to be proud of the tradition in Tallahassee, because it was a hostile crowd last night, and very exciting place to play a football game. I think our players thoroughly enjoyed it. We were looking forward to going down there to play the game, and we needed that football game. We needed to win it, of course, but we needed to get in that kind of atmosphere and play and find out and just see what we're made out of. And I liked what I saw last night. I think that we couldn't have won that football game without total oneness on our football team. The defense got the ball back at the end for the offense to have an opportunity to score. And, of course, the offense rose to the occasion. And it's just so many individuals that stood out in the game last night, and we'll talk about them as the game goes on.
Okay, and let's get the birthday guys now. Brent Fullwood, Pat Washington, and Arthur Johnson in the crazy post-game dressing room.
Y'all get dressed and let's go to...
Wait, it's my birthday.
Come on, I said we'd come out.
This one for you, Bear.
Come out. Happy birthday.
Hey, hold on. Hey,
Jay. Pat Washington.
I want you to know when this was fourth and three, Patrick called his own number out there tonight.
Get up there, Pat. Get up there so we can sing it to you, boy.
Just sing.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
This week?
21.
That's a nice birthday. No turnovers, huh?
It is.
Is that the best birthday present you can think of?
It's next to the best. I can't tell you the other one.
Okay. Well, they hit it and they broke and it popped straight up to me. I just took off.
You said you just return it all the way and then ask if it was okay.
Well, that's better safe than sorry. You know,
were you surprised when I gave you a touchdown?
I wanted it. I promise you that. But it was so funny. Me and my wife in our quiet time, she prayed that I would somehow make a big play this weekend. I can't wait to get home.
That's an answer to prayer. I wanted
a big answer, and it shows you the power of prayer right there and what the Lord can do. And it's unbelievable. I just running down the field all alone. I hadn't done that since high school, you know.
Crowd, I bet you record noise too.
It had to be. It was a beautiful night for football. It was warm, but it wasn't hot. But it got hot before the night was over. They gave us good field position in the kickoffs all night long. I guess they was afraid to kick it to Brent. But we start out right here. Pat Washington runs a bootleg for about 15 yards.
That's going to be a good play for Auburn.
And this time. And come back the next play in the greatest catch I've ever seen in my life right here, where Pat actually juggles a ball, picks it up, and hits Freddie Wagan. And Freddie, how he got around underneath that guy and kept his eye on the football and got both hands on it, I'll never know. But he catches the ball about the 3-yard line, I guess, and we take this one in to score. Pat hurried his throw there a little bit and had Jeff wide open in the end zone.
Well, watch the blocks here.
And Brent takes it in. I guess that's 4th and 1. Yeah. And we get the go-ahead touchdown right there. 7. I told Jeff Park's girlfriend Friday, I believe, that we were going to throw him a touchdown pass, but we just didn't. It didn't work out. But anyway, Florida State comes right back, and you're going to see them. They've got a lot of talented athletes, the best skilled people that I've ever seen on one team in my life.
Jones and Hester are remarkable wide.
Well, that's a remarkable player right there. Allen and, of course, that quarterback, Eric Thomas, did a great job last night. And they move this one down, and we stop them, and they kick a field goal. And I feel like we're doing pretty good when we hold them to a field goal.
Okay.
We come back, and they're on offense again, and there's a fine play right there by Victor Beasley. Actually knocked the ball loose from Thomas, and come back. Great play right here. Arthur Johnson, Gerald Williams, and Harold Hallman. And you can see the ball come squirting out of there, and Jim Bone comes up with a turnover. And Phil, you know, we did not have a turnover last night.
That's right. We got on a couple to save.
We take this one down and get a field goal. Collis Campbell, you're going to see CC make a big run later on. Offensive line coming off of football extremely well right there. And Florida State came out with a different alignment than we were expecting and gave us some problems with it early as far as our running game is concerned. But we took advantage of some of the things that they were doing as the night went along.
Late in the first quarter now.
They come back and they just did a great job of throwing the football backside, front side, post routes off of play action passes. And
same drive, second
quarterback,
quarter.
Great. Our defense comes back here. We'd actually take them out of field goal range here with 2 sacks out, one by Kevin Green and Ben Thomas and Gerald Williams, Harold Hallman. Greg Carr makes a big play on the sack right there on the blitz. And again, we've got them back out of field position. They punt down the ball, and we don't get the ball off the goal line right here. And this has to strike.
3rd and 3 here is a good run by Brent Fullwood, who really ran tough.
He ran good, and of course, you can see the Florida State is, you know, they're playing hard too. I guess this is the 5th or 6th punt that Florida State has blocked this year. And that's one thing that we worked extremely hard on during the course of the week is to prevent that from happening. But good execution on their part, poor on our part, they get one blocked. As Gerald Williams and Harold Hallman again, stopping that fullback inside. Again, the option pass coming down the line. Eric Thomas hits a tight end and runs on for the touchdown, and it's 10-10.
But not for long.
I was very, very proud of our entire football team last night. You take Eddie Graham right here that's running this kickoff back. Eddie didn't practice the day last week with a pulled groin and comes up with a big play on the kickoff here. We got Collis Campbell, great block by Tim Jesse. Good block right there by Trey Gaines. Got folks down there in front of him trying to win on every down. Tommy Agee and I don't know who the other guy was down there. Maybe Ron Middleton or Stacy Searles. Randy Stokes out there blocking for him.
He stayed in bounds, too, but only by about an inch.
Ron Milton's been playing extremely well for us. Jeff Park starts at tight end, but Ron's been playing so well, he was one of our captains for the ball game. And we knew that for our offense to be complete, that we had to get the ball pitched on the corners more than we've been getting it pitched, and we worked extremely hard on it last week, Coach Casey and Coach Pro. And here they throw it back across the field, and it's a forward pass, and it's really a big play for us because it backs them up, and we hold them and get the ball in good field position again. Isn't that Caesar making the play, knocking them out of bounds?
They start at the 4, and they're out at the 8-yard line on second down on this play.
As Harold Hallman, I don't know if anybody in the conference is playing better at nose guard right now than Harold Hallman. He's just making big play after big play.
Third down.
As two linebackers, Greg Carr and Ben McCurdy and Gerald Williams coming back in on the play.
They have to punt. This is a 3rd and 5 play right here.
As Pat throwing to Freddie. Little stop route. That guy right there.
3rd and 15 here.
This is a great throw and catch on the part of Pat Washington and Trey Gaines. Puts the ball at the 10-yard line.
They get a penalty.
He pitches to Brent. There's Tim Jesse out front blocking, and Brent takes it in for the touchdown. There's a good block right there by Tommy Agee. We start getting the execution on the corner like that, and we're going to be a much better offensive football team than we were last night because of it.
Brent scored 3 times on the night, but they come right back quickly, too. They can score.
Is throwing out to Hester, David King, and Arthur Johnson. This is just a busted assignment here. We took the play fake and let the guy run free, and again, we knew that they had that speed and were deep through it all the time, and we just broke down in our coverage. And you know, it's not something that you want to do, but it's something that I hope we can learn. Here's a reverse, and they do a great job with the reverses, and that's a little Darren Hallman for them. And Alvin Briggs makes the tackle.
Late in the second quarter, just before the half, and they're going to score.
They get a penalty right here for offensive lineman downfield. The ball was actually thrown across the line of scrimmage. And great play right here by Gerald Robinson. Gerald actually caught that ball right there. And we come back and get one play off and take it down. And go ahead, what was the score?
22-17 at the half.
22-17 at the half.
We'll be back. Just a diversity feature today. To remind you folks in the West Central Alabama area to avenge loss there, Coach. Here we go.
Marion's playing pretty well.
That's right. Here we go into the second half now.
Phil, I think Florida State made a mistake with that decision at the opening kickoff because we won the toss and we deferred our decision till the half, and they chose to give us the ball the first half, and we ended up getting 2 touchdowns out of it. As a ball on the ground, which we don't like to see, but we certainly like to see it pop up in our guy's hands where he can go ahead and score with it. I think a good Lord smiled on us last night, Phil. It was something special about it. It looked like it, we were out of it. Sometimes a good Lord has a way of not putting any more on you than you can.
That's what he says.
Carry.
That's what he said.
We were taken to the limit last night for sure, and it was, like I said, I know that our defense got a lot of points and a lot of yards against it, but, I can't. They've won some football games for us this year when the offense was struggling, and it's a team game. And as Greg Allen,
that was a great run. He broke a couple of tackles.
Great play, great player. There's a key play right there, and you can't see it on film, but I think Arthur Johnson got a 5-yard face mask penalty there. Here's a reverse. There's a clip. It was not called, and that's what I got so upset about too. And I said something to one of the officials, and he said he saw it, but it wasn't his call to make.
Oh.
And that really upset me. So that makes it,
29-24.
And they come right back. And that guy right there is a great football player. He's going to make a great pro player.
This was Auburn's worst time in the third quarter. You all were not moving the ball, and they were.
Right. they came out with a hot hand. And
that's their first lead of the game.
That's right, and they come right back and make a two-point play, and it's a three-point ball game, man. Isn't that correct?
32-29.
We're struggling a little bit here, but we hadn't given up. They're still scratching and biting, and we're going to get it done. And right here, Freddie Wagan makes another spectacular catch, and they actually got to try to tackle him to keep him from catching it. There's Pat on the bootleg, and he's going to score right here. And that was an outstanding play. But this play is called back. I don't know. That was a close call right there. I feel like the guy turned his back. He's running, and I don't know how that's a judgment call. And, of course, it went against us, and they come right back here and move the football and take it down and kick another field goal, I guess, don't they?
Fourth and three right here, and they move a lot of
folks. If that's not the intentional movement to draw you off sides and the guy, then
big play, you know, they get a first down.
Anyway, they go down and get a field goal, and that was a fine play by Ben Thomas. And
we're in the fourth quarter now. They have to kick the field goal, and that gives them a 6-point lead.
And I still feel good. I don't know how much time is left in the game, about 7 minutes against something. Like, but they come back and stop us here now. And is this our touchdown drive?
No, this is the come from behind the first time. This is early in the fourth quarter.
Okay.
Second and 10 coming up.
I guess we do it twice, don't we?
Right.
All right. That's
it.
Pat
does get confusing.
Pitching to Kyle Collins, and of course Pat had to have his finest night last night. And
what a night!
How many yards he rushed for? He threw for 100.
Watch Tim Jesse here.
All of our backs ran hard, and our offensive line, you can see them coming off of football. And
third and five right here. Great play.
Good block right there. I don't know who the lead blocker was, but as Kyle Collins and getting it in the end zone for the touchdown.
Come from behind, number one. Here they come, though. We're midway of the fourth quarter, 10:42 to go in the game.
As Snipes played extremely well against us last year, played good against us again last night. There's Joe Robinson with some pressure, and come back across the middle, and we were hitting the guy, and
he's
tough. Reaches out there. They're great receivers.
Third and five.
We had the blitz coming, and they hit us with the draw, and broken clean that season, saved a touchdown. I tell you, we were having a hard time. You know, I like to be fish or foul. That was awful close right there, Phil. Did he get his foot down?
I don't know.
That's a big play right there. That might have been the biggest play of the ball game, because if they score 2 points there, then we've got to make two to win.
They are ahead now, 41-36. They have a.
This is a fourth down play right here, and we called timeout, and Pat came over to the sideline. We were talking about what we wanted to call, and. And Pat actually called that play himself. He said, let me run it on the bootleg. And it was a great play right here by Freddie Wagan. Breaks a tackle, and how long was that play, Bill? 35 yards. Pat comes right back and hits Jeff Parks for another 15 yards. Pitches to Brent Fullwood here, and Brent's going to take it to the corner for about 9. I wanted to run the clock out. I didn't want to get in there quite this quick.
But you take it.
Make the first down, yeah, and Brent takes it in for the touchdown. And
48 seconds to go. They have one timeout.
It's wild. I'm telling you, it's wild. And they do a great job on the kickoff. We're running back out to about the 30-yard line and lightning strikes. A big guy walks late, and there's Gerald Robinson and Harold Hallman.
Here Gerald's he comes again.
Gerald's coming again. Watch him. Look out. Pull it up, and they come back and throw the. They can't stop the clock now. They've used their last timeout, and I want to tell you something. You think conserving timeouts is not important in a football game? Then you know they could have used an extra one at the end.
We'll be back in just like a win like that.
First down, 10 Seminoles at their own 27. Handoff goes all over. No, fake by Thomas. Throws it long to Hester. Hester chasing. He makes the catch at the 45. It's a touchdown. Jesse Hester, the bomb from Thomas. 73 yards, and the Noles are back in it. Holloman to the near side, the only wide receiver. Two tight ends. The tailback toss comes to Allen. Handoff goes to Holloman. Holloman looks for a block. He gets into the 10, to the 5. Holloman, touchdown! Down Holloman! And the big block was there.
The Bobby Bowden Show, brought to you in part by Likes Brothers, makers of family favorite ham, bacon, and sausage. Old-fashioned goodness is better. By your Florida and South Georgia Ford dealers. And by Production Credit Association and your Federal Land Bank Association. We speak your language. By Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida. We hear you, and we're working on the answer. By Scotty's, serving Florida with more than 100 convenient locations. By Dairy Farmers Incorporated, local producers of real fresh Florida milk. By Gulf Power, the good sense people. And by Seminole Boosters Incorporated, the team behind the teams at Florida State. And now here's Gene Deckerhoff and Florida State head coach Bobby Bowden.
Hello once again, welcome to our show, and Coach Bobby Bowden, what an outstanding football game at Doak Campbell Stadium Saturday night. I don't think there has ever been a more exciting football game than the one the fans that came to the stadium saw on Saturday.
Well, it was a beautiful night for football. We had our largest crowd ever there. Auburn, gosh, they must have had 15,000 people down there. It's as excitable night as I've ever been through. Our kids played a great game. Auburn played a great game. It's really one of those games where we just ran out of time. We had just completed a pass down to that 38 or 39 yard line, and we needed one more play maybe to kick a field goal and win it.
Bobby, it was one of those type of games where you really couldn't find a loser, except the final score was 42-41, Auburn by 1 point. Over 1,000 yards of offense, an exciting college football game. We've got first half highlights, a great moment in Florida State football history coming up. All sorts of excitement on our program. Stay with us. We'll be right back with the first half highlight. Opening kickoff to the final gun. Quite an exciting football game Saturday night, Bobby Bowden.
Oh, it was a great night. I tell you, the weather cooperated and the fans were just outstanding. I tell you, you talk about college football. I've never seen a setting like one the other night. We kick off. They have a great kickoff return man, Fullwood, and we did not want him to handle the ball, so we kicked it short. Stanley Scott makes a real fine tackle there on the opening kickoff. And here comes, they run a bootleg right off the bat. Break contained, start off with a nice play. And I want you to watch their first play here. They fumble a football, whereas we should have made a play out of it. Instead, they get a gainer. Our corner went up for the interception, and their receiver just went up and took it away. Then they come in, and we stop them on first down. Then they come, I think they score on the second down. Fullwood, number 22, a Florida boy who had a great game against us. He's tackled by Eric Williams from Clearwater, Florida. And Auburn takes a 7-0 lead right off the bat. And it was a play of big plays. If people like, I tell you, if every game could be like this, you'd have to enlarge your state. You have to double all your teams. Roosevelt Snipes on the kickoff return, brings the ball out, gets us good field position. Eric Thomas at quarterback, Cletus Jones on the fullback up the middle. Offensive line block real good. Cletus got hurt. Eric Thomas had a great night. 354 yards passing, 4 touchdown passes, 18 out of 29, I believe, Gene. He had a super day. Offensive line blocked good. Darren Holloman from Tallahassee, Florida, played real well. There's Greg Allen running the football. Makes a real nice run here, a great run. Picks up yards when he should have lost about 3. They played our sweep real good. Greg got knocked out in the ball game. He got knocked out and couldn't think and did not get to play the last quarter and a half, really, and we could have sure used him. Hassan Jones had a great game for us. There's a nice, here's Greg Allen here on a good first down, where he breaks a few tackles, and we're moving the ball real good here. Here's Tony Smith from Miami, Florida on a nice 4 or 5 yard gain up the middle. And here's Eric Mack, hands off to Greg Allen, who makes another fine first down for Florida State. But then we bog down, and Derek Schmidt comes in, kicks a field goal, and Auburn is 7, Florida State 3. There's very little punting in this football game here, Gene. We kick off short again. We've kicked off a little bit too short. And Billy Allen, number 31, in on the tackle. Here comes Fullwood. But our corner, Jerome McCoy over there. Isaac Williams led our team in tackles with 14. Isaac Williams had a real outstanding ball game. In fact, I thought our defensive line did a real good job. We had a hard time stopping our outside. That's where they made most of their yards. And here's Cletus Jones running the football up the middle. Real fine running by Cletus from Miami, Florida. As I said, Cletus got hurt in the ball game. Didn't play hard in the second half.
There's Greg Allen again. But here's Eric Thomas on a real fine run here. Picks up a first down for Florida State. They hit him real good, but it was a first down. Here's a pitch to Greg Allen. They knocked the ball out, and we didn't get it, and they recover it now. I think it set up another score for them. Darrell Gray on the tackle there. Real fine tackle by Isaac Williams and Garth Jacks, number 84. And they kick a field goal here and take a 10-3 lead. And, boy, what an exciting football game this was. Okay, they kick the ball up short, and Darren Holloman picks the ball up. Pat Carter from Sarasota, Florida, blocking 87 out there. Galen White from Atlanta, Georgia. And there comes Snipes up the middle on a big first down. Hassan Jones, 88, blocking. Now, here's Eric Thomas hitting Hassan across the middle. Boy, Hassan played a great game. I'm so pleased with our players. There's Jamie Dukes leading the sweep. Eric Thomas runs for another Florida State first down, picks up a block from Jesse Hester downfield. Okay, here's our first punt. And Lewis Berry punts the ball, real good punt, punts the ball out of bounds down inside the 10-yard line. And here they come, but we get a good play there out of Isaac Williams again, Fred Jones, and there's a nice play there by Henry Taylor, number 58, our senior linebacker from Milledgeville, Georgia. Look at the crowd. You can see the wave there in the stadium. Boy, that's a great picture of the wave. Okay, Lenny Shavers from DeLand, Florida, blocks our fifth punt of the year and sets up our touchdown here. Watch. Eric Thomas coming down the line, and he hits Pete Patton from Venice, Florida for a touchdown. And now I think we're only behind by, well, that tied it up, 10-10. I was thinking they got ahead of us more than that. That's right. Then they score on this long run. Okay, we kick the football off. Number 21 takes it, and we get pretty good covers there. And I believe old Barco, our kicker, makes the stop. Now, here's the touchdown that really hurt us right here, about a 69-yarder. And we could not hem him up. And he runs right down the sideline for a dadgum touchdown. A great run. Great blocking by Auburn. And we had shots at him, but we couldn't get him down. And it's 16-10. Our defense, they got a lot of points, but they got all their scores on long runs. Well, we did, too. It was that type of night. Their number 14 played a great game. And here comes Fullwood from down around St. Cloud, Florida, playing for them. Did a real good job for them. They tried a two-point play, but Eric Williams on it very good. We had a good blitz on, and we stopped them. Now they kick off to us, and the ball goes back to Snipes again, and he takes the football and makes a very nice return. They corner him down there, but we brought the ball out pretty good on Auburn. And here's a pass out to Jesse Hester, and he makes the first down for Florida State. Eric Thomas back, takes the ball. He finds Jesse Hester down the middle, and it's a touchdown, and now we're back in the football game. So it's 22-17, and I believe that a halftime score, Gene?
Yep, 5 points.
We're 5 points down at the half. Derek Schmidt kicks the extra point, and really one of the most exciting first halves of football I've seen, but it's nothing compared to what it's going to be the second half.
22-17 at halftime. A great catch by Jesse Hester. He just caught up to that ball on that long bomb, and you're right in the thick of things.
Yeah, Eric lit it up real nice. When he threw the ball, Jesse wasn't clear, but when the ball came down, he was way out front. So it was a great job of execution.
I guess that's why they call him the Jet, Coach Fountain. The second half highlights are just around the corner, and coming up, a great moment in Florida State football history with Burt Reynolds. Stay with
us. Fountain Show.
Great moments in Florida State football. From 54, 30 years later, we're at Doe Campbell Stadium, Coach Bob.
Yeah,
thriller.
I tell you, those are two great guys right there. Watch this kickoff return here now. You talk about a bad break. They fumble a kickoff. We recover it. Oh, I had a chance to recover it. Jumps up in their hands, right in the dadgum guy's hands. He runs for a touchdown. Now, instead of being behind by 5, we're behind by 12. And it just couldn't get a break in that order. Auburn did not turn the ball over a time, Gene, and they had been turning it over. Their passer, I think Auburn has found themselves now because their quarterback has finally put the great game together as far as I was concerned. And they really look good. But ours does, too. I've said the other night that Auburn would have to be a great team to come in here and beat us because I knew our boys were well prepared and were ready to play football. And to beat us in Tallahassee, Auburn was going to have a great team. And I really think they're about to reach that stride right now, looks like it. But here's our football team. And here's Greg Allen. Now, Greg Allen got knocked cuckoo and really didn't know where he was the second half of the ball game.
And Don Falls had to take him out of the game. But he sure gave us some good running. And that might have been where he got KO'd there, I'm not sure. But some way he took a lick on the head and couldn't remember. Here's a reverse we ran. And Eric Thomas throws a key block and got his head in front on it. And Darren Holloman scores on the reverse. And that keeps us in the football game. Our kids kept fighting back. They just would not give up last night. It seemed like we would get behind by 12 points several times, and then we came on back, and later on, of course, got ahead. But Auburn's that was a great tackle by Billy Allen there. Great tackle by Billy Allen. Look, we're gonna play a little bit. Jerome McCoy makes a tackle there along with Henry Taylor, and looked like we were about in the ball game. Isaac Williams, 45, led our team in tackles with 14 tackles, but he played a great game. Had we won that ball game, I believe Isaac Williams might have been lineman of the week. And Eric Thomas might have been back of the week. Here's a look at another great pass by Eric. He just puts the ball up. And Jesse Hester makes a beautiful catch. Now we're down there back threatening again. Now here, Eric throws a real fine pass here to Hassan, I believe. Hassan Jones, great catch. I've really never been so proud of our wide receivers as I was in that ball game. There's Hester comes right back with a two-point conversion. And now we're ahead of them by 3 points. Florida State, 32-29. They kick off, can't handle it. They die down in the end zone. Ooh, we need another block punt. We didn't get it. Darren Holloman handles the ball there, tries to get a return, but they got everybody down there, and we can't get anything out of it. Here's a real fine run by Snipes again, and 61 Danny Morris pulling out. He gets Hassan Jones across the middle. Another real fine catch. 49 Tony Smith from Miami, Florida, down on the play. Here's a Pete Patton catching a pass. Pick football, not quite a first down, but we go into a shift there of a spread, and Auburn jumps offside and gives Florida State a first down. And here's 96 Pete Patton blocking out here for Snipes. We fumble the football. It rolls out of bounds. Jamie Duke, 64, blocking. John Iannotta, 77. Jerry Rypel, 53, in there at center. And Parrish Bark at the other tackle. And we come in and kick another field goal, and now we go up, what, by 6 points?
6 point lead.
6 point lead, 35-29, and you're hoping that'll be all the scoring we win, but Auburn was not through. Here comes up, nice tackle again by number 83, Stanley Scott. He played a real good game. 57, there's Jesse Solomon from Madison, Florida. A real fine run by the tailback in. They pitch the football out and score around our end again. So they made their big runs around the end. They had not done it all year. They'd been taking everything back up inside, everything. And we really felt like we had to stop them up inside. So they adjusted well. Their coaches knew what they were doing. And it's a ball game, gee. I really don't think our kids deserve to lose. And yet Auburn didn't deserve to lose either. It was just that kind of a football game. There's Danny Morris leading old Snipes. And Snipes picks up a first down for Florida State. They got ahead of us. Our kids come out. A great play by Eric Thomas. Look at Hassan. Look at Hassan fighting to stay on his feet. Boy, he played a great game. I couldn't say enough good things about our players. Nice run there again by Snipes. They just deserved to win. You talk about a big play. Look here. Snipes just nearly took this one in. But I think Eric hits Hassan again on a great catch. Another great catch. And now we got a 41-36 lead. And had a chance to win it right here, Gene, but couldn't quite do it. You have to give Auburn a lot of credit. Boy, look at that guy running the football. Number 40 is Greg Newell from Panama City there, chasing. And here they come on the option. Now let's stop them. Here's that big tailback. That's Jerome McCoy on a real fine block with Darrell Gray and Brian McCrary in there. This is a nice play here by number Billy Allen, number 31. Gerald Nichols in on the tackle. Here's a draw play to Snipes. Runs for another first down. Gosh, we like to pull this game out, didn't we? Nice block there. Tony Smith put on their linebacker. Another great run there by. All right, we punt the football. Now, here's the last drive. Now, if we could have stopped them here, we could win the football game. But they just do a good job. They came up with a 4th and 5, I think, a 4th and 3, and just made it by a yard. Their quarterback came through. Here comes that tailback of theirs on a nice run. Jesse Solomon hits him, and somebody else pins him in, but here they go for the bounces it outside. I tell you, they had some good backs. I mean, we had to play stop right where we had to stop it. They go for a two-point conversion, and Brian McCrary and Mark Mayhew from Tallahassee. Now, here's Carlton Scott, a freshman, has great speed. We put him in there hoping he could break the kickoff, and you know what he did? Look, took the ball up to the 39-yard line, and here's the last play of the game when Gaynor catches his pass and gets out of bounds, and when he ran out of bounds, there was 1 second on the clock. I looked up there and saw it, but by the time the official could wave it dead, the ball game was over, and we could not get another shot. Now, Derek Schmidt had kicked a 67-yard field goal in practice the week before. I watched him. I told Hobbs, I said, I want to see how far he can kick the ball. And if we could have got one more play in, we might have won the ball game. So it's a ball game in which we just ran out of time. But how many people have said that?
42-41, 83 points in the ball game, a new record for a combined total of offensive yards, 1,063 yards, two great football teams, and what a ball game.
Yeah, we nearly got 600 yards against Auburn. I thought that'd be impossible, but bad things, we didn't lose. We didn't win the game.
Florida State is now 4-1-1. Next week it's Tulane, and that's not going to be easy. We'll have a scouting report on the Green Wave in just a moment. Florida State loses to Auburn. Next week it's Tulane. Had a lot of boosters up from the Orlando area. Want to tip our hat to that booster club, Seminole Booster Club of Greater Orlando. Rob Hackley down that way, Stan Creel.
No, they do a great job. We enjoy going every spring. Now here comes a football team that's gotten a lot better, Tulane. Started off, lost the first two games of the year, and they've won their last two. They beat Vanderbilt and Southern Mississippi the last 2 weeks. They're on a roll right now, and of course they started us on our downfall last year, Gene. Ought to be a good football game. They got a great quarterback, this young man here, Karcher. Transferred in from Notre Dame. He'd make some good plays. They lost a very close football game to the University of Kentucky, who's undefeated. So we need a win this week, boy.
We certainly do. And we're playing again at Doe Campbell Stadium. We had 58,000 plus at the stadium on Saturday against Auburn. We may have that bigger crowd this weekend. We look forward to it.
Well, if it's exciting as last week, it'll be a barn burner.
Barn burner, that's exactly right. Thank you very much for joining us this week, and join us again next time for the Bobby Bowden Show.
Has been brought to you in... Trick Avenue.
Oh, yeah.
a young America, standing right through the picture windows, finds it slinking back upon, because as it passes a bullet in the sting, hitting for bits, taking the pain, but the freak and his life are for nothing, this is a step and cuts his hand, showing nothing is worth, like the sounds of cripples, where a ball by the skin of his gun. A young American,
young American, young American, she's a young American. All night.
Well, she wants a young American, all the way from Washington. Her breadwinner begs off the bottom floor. Live for just these 20 years. Have to die for the 50 more.
All night.
She wants a young American.
Thank you.
girl like you. I will tell her. Never want another girl like you.